Montreal is the world's second largest French-speaking city, and it has thrived as a cosmopolitan communications and economic hub due to its location on the St. Lawrence River. Welcome back to Hotel Review, and today we're going to list a few of the best places you must visit if you're ever planning to go to Montreal. If you roam about Old Montreal, you most certainly will wind up in the Old Port, a bustling region along the St. Lawrence River. There's a lot to do here, from riding the enormous Ferris wheel to climbing the iconic clock tower to screaming down a zip line that drops from terrifying heights across vast areas of sea. Strolling around the area, and you can take in some of the 10 intriguing public art exhibitions and see a show at the IMAX Theater. Or you can brush up on your knowledge at the Montreal Science Centre. Or you can always get a cup of coffee and take a seat on one of the many sunny terraces to take it all in. The green lung near the city center, Mont-Royal, rises 233 meters above the city. A journey around this charming park will allow you to admire monuments to Jacques Cartier and King George VI, or you can relax by La Cour Castres. And you can visit the cemetery on the western slope where the city's various ethnic groups have rested in a place for centuries. A spectacular panorama of the entire 51-kilometer length of the Île de Montréal and the St. Lawrence may be seen more from the summit, or rather a platform above the cross. The vista extends to the Adirondack Mountains in the United States of America on clear days. Parc Maisonneuve is the site of Montreal's amazingly inventive botanical park, which is located high above the city on grounds that hosted the 1976 Summer Olympic Games. Plants from all over the world are planted in 30 themed gardens and 10 exhibition greenhouses, representing a wide scale of climates. The outdoor gardens include those devoted to alpine, aquatic, medicinal, shade, useful, and even toxic plants. Expo 67 was held on the Île Sainte-Hélène, named after Samuel de Champlain's wife, and an artificial island of Notre-Dame. They're currently known as Parc Jean-Drapeau and provide a variety of family-friendly activities. The Biosphere, a relic from the 1967 World's Fair, is now a museum dedicated to the environmental issues. The structure is fashioned in the shape of a sphere and is the world's largest of its kind. The Pointe à Callière, on the corner of Palace Royal and Vieux Montreal, is today distinguished by a stunning modern edifice holding an archaeological and history museum. The market and parade ground were located on Place Royale until later government buildings displaced them, making it the heart of life in early and colonial Montreal. However, vestiges of these early streets and foundations may still be located beneath today's Montreal, which you can explore during your tour to the museum. The journey through the city's history begins beneath, where you may wander among the city's original stone-paved streets, drainage ditches, and ground floors of 17th century structures. As you climb through the museum, the story unfolds in layers of history recounted through relics, maps, and exhibitions. Special exhibitions are held all year round and include a vast spectrum of history and archaeology. The Place des Arts is a large art complex in Canada dedicated to both visual and performing arts. The Montreal Symphony Orchestra, the Grands Ballets Canadiens, and the Opera de Montréal are among the city's major cultural institutions, and its different stages and rehearsal rooms host a wide range of theater, music, dance, films, and events. These are arranged around a wide esplanade featuring works of art, fountains, and water cascades, which is a popular event location. The most prominent of these is the annual Summer Festival International de Jazz de Montréal, which attracts tourists from all over the globe and features some of the biggest names in jazz. It takes place in late June and early July and attracts guests from everywhere. Square Saint-Louis, located near the Sherbrooke Metro Station, is one of Montreal's loveliest ancient squares, set in a turn-of-the-century French-Canadian residential district. There are still a few lovely Victorian residences in the small lanes surrounding the tree-shaded square. Some of it has been converted to charming eateries. Rue Saint-Denis, which runs parallel to St. Laurent on the square's eastern edge, is one of Montreal's hippest shopping, arts, and dining avenues. Boutiques, bistros, and cafes have been converted from historic structures. At one end, Saint-Denis begins in the student-friendly Quartier Latin neighborhood and continues west into the trendy Plateau neighborhood, which is home to independent designers and chef-run restaurants. Thank you for watching. We hope this list helped you pick out the attractions you need to see when you visit Montreal. If you found this video helpful, please like the video and subscribe to the channel.